Let's learn about tubular reabsorption and secretion. Let's begin by going over a few basic processes. The functional unit of the kidney is the nephron. The nephron makes urine. Blood enters the nephron at the afferent arteriole. The afferent arteriole brings blood to the first part of the nephron, known as the glomerulus, which is the filter. The blood is filtered by the glomerulus, and the filtrate enters the proximal convoluted tubule of the nephron. Here, substances can move back and forth between the blood in the peritubular capillaries and the tubule. In tubular reabsorption, substances move from the tubule to the peritubular capillaries. In tubular secretion, substances move from the peritubular capillaries to the tubule. Let's take a closer look at how this happens. Here we see a diagram of a kidney tubule along with the cells lining it, the interstitium, and the peritubular capillaries. Remember that in tubular reabsorption, substances move from the tubule to the peritubular capillaries. Sodium moves from the tubule into the cell by way of co-transporter proteins that also transport glucose, amino acids, and vitamins into the cell. These substances end up back in the blood. These transporters are sometimes called symporters. The tubular cells also have sodium-potassium pumps that move sodium back into the interstitium. The sodium-potassium pumps use ATP to create an interstitial sodium gradient, which helps to draw sodium out of the tubule. A very small amount of sodium moves between the cells through leaky cell junctions. We call this paracellular movement. Other ions move between cells as well. These include magnesium, calcium, potassium, and chloride. Water is also reabsorbed by osmosis. The sodium gradient works to produce an osmotic pressure to pull water out of the tubule. Water also moves between cells via the paracellular route. Lipid-soluble substances are reabsorbed by diffusion. Remember that lipid-soluble substances can move across cell membranes. In the distal convoluted tubule, antidiuretic hormone makes aquaporins, or water channels, available for water reabsorption. Aldosterone promotes more sodium reabsorption and potassium secretion in the distal convoluted tubule and collecting duct by opening sodium and potassium channels. Hydrogen ions from the blood are secreted by the sodium hydrogen antiporter, which moves sodium in one direction while moving hydrogen ions in the other. The secretion of hydrogen ions works to balance blood pH. Bicarbonate ions are also reabsorbed. Carbon dioxide diffuses into the cell. Once inside, it combines with water to form carbonic acid, which dissociates into hydrogen and bicarbonate ions. The bicarbonate ions are co-transported out of the cell with sodium and end up in the peritubular capillaries. Urea cycles through the nephron. Urea flows into the descending limb of the nephron loop and then to the ascending limb and distal convoluted tubule. The collecting duct is permeable to urea, so it flows back into the interstitium of the medulla. Urea can move back into the descending limb of the nephron loop because it is permeable to urea. This creates a cycle which works to maintain the high solute concentration gradient in the medulla. We hope you have learned something about tubular reabsorption and secretion, and see you next time.